I admit that I did a less than optimal job of setting up for first bull run. I put my career point into AO to expand to 10 units. I forgot to fill up my supply wagon, which you should always remember to do. Since the reputation menu will change after bull run, I took Gibbon and left him in the academy for later. Right now I want Wagner and Brewster to stay as my division commanders until they hit general. I topped off my units in 1st Division with recruits, then created a new ordnance rifle battery. I should have given him a better officer to get the perk, but I didn't, so that was my second mistake. I topped off the infantry in my 2nd Division based on how many weapons I had left over of each type. I could have gone bigger if I wanted to buy weapons or to use some of the lesser quality ones, but I was good with this group for Bull Run as it is. I then made a carbine calve unit and started first Bull Run. The only units you get for Phase 1 are the allies that come from the east, then your core units that come in from the north. All the rest of the reinforcements don't come in until Phase 2. With that said, Matthews Hill is pretty easy most of the time. I think Bartow is always split and has some artillery, but nobody else is near Matthews Hill, unless a unit moves away from the east to go to the west. I've only had one instance where it turned into a real fight, because the 4th South Carolina, Hampton's Legion, and the Louisiana Tigers all came up there for some reason, which was fine because it made Phase 2 a lot easier with all of those units off the field. Back in the base game, I would set up in this northern woodline, and then in the mod, I'd gotten away from it. But in this version, I've got back into using this position. With the truncated timing of the battles and phases, every little bit helps. By setting up here, my troops don't have to move through as much forest to move down to the river later on. And also, Bartow seems to like to move away from Matthews Hill a little bit and go into the trees to the right. So if you set up in the traditional position to the far left, he may not be able to see you at all. Of course, you can always send out someone in advance to get the AI's attention like I end up doing. The cons to being in this location are that if I move too far south, I trigger an early end to the phase every time. And sometime after phase two starts, I get too far ahead of my allies that come in from the west, and then my crew ends up doing most of the fighting while the allies are still getting into position. In previous versions of the mod, it was fairly common for the CSA to just abandon the area around the ford so you could start crossing unimpeded. In this version, I've had some pretty serious battles at the ford, because even though the 4th South Carolina leaves, other units tend to come up and intercept my allies as I try to cross there. In this playthrough, that doesn't happen, but be aware of it in your campaigns. Hampton's Legion is a 3-star unit, and this is the second time it has charged on the right. Normally, once an AI unit is routing hard the other way, I will disengage to preserve some condition and so that my guys aren't dragged into the range of enemy shooters. But with them being a 3-star unit, I don't want to let go of this tiger's tail if there's a chance he's going to surrender or shatter. One thing that I would have done a little different here is not having so many of my allies cross the river to the left. Having a few enter on the point to get into the woods is fine, but it is generally safer to have your units shift to the right of the battlefield and come in from that direction, which I do with my core units and most of my artillery. Here I've put Howard, Wilcox, and Franklin in a bad position, so try to avoid that as much as you can. Thank you. One of the things that caught me off guard at Bull Run the first time I played it was that I took the VP before I was ready. In the past, you could get all your guys into place, and then you had to walk up right on top of the VP in order to trigger it. Well, all through the mod, any of the VPs that previously required you to get really close have had their area expanded, so you'll capture those VPs much earlier than you would before. Bull Run has at least one alternative spawning location that I'm aware of for the counterattack in Phase 3. 4 out of the 5 times I've played it, anywhere from 3 to 5 infantry brigades have approached from the bridge behind, so you should set a few units behind you until you know whether anyone is coming from that direction. I put 3 infantry there, and then I may shift some skirmishers or cav that way if they have their hands full trying to defend the bridge. Whereas you could full clear most battles in the previous versions of the mod, it is much harder to do now. In my observations, the more aggressive the AI is early on, the easier it is to clear at the end, because the enemy forces are spent and you just spend your time mopping up the leftovers. But if the AI is more passive, it will still have a decently strong force at the end, and that's much harder to clear. It was pretty even with the cav and guns. The CSA had about 10,000 more troops. I had about 4,600 total casualties, with 1,100 being my core units. I lost Bobby Woods here, which sucks. Well, that wraps up Bull Run. I'll see you in camp heading into River Crossing. I hope this has been helpful. Thank you for watching.